Well, it was another home game and another embarrassing loss for the Jaguars at home, really. At Everbank Field, they've been bad every time. And, you know, I'm not even really all that upset about it. Maybe on the stages of grief, maybe I've reached the acceptance phase, but I guess I kind of expected to see this happen. I was hoping that it wouldn't. I was hoping that we'd see the progress that we saw against the Packers. And in a way, I felt like we almost kind of did and towards the end, but really, no, this offense was terrible from the beginning. The first three drives of the game were three and outs, and they put the defense on the field far too much, and that's what really dug the giant hole for them that they couldn't make up. Blaine Gabbert was all right. If you look at the stat book, he completed about 70% of his passes, hit two touchdowns. Justin Blackmon caught his first of the game. But really, it wasn't a good game for him. He was bad early on. He had only 110 yards passing going into the fourth quarter. And Justin Blackmon had another bad game. He dropped the ball. He showed that same poor awareness of getting his feet in bounds on the sideline. And he didn't fight for what could have been it was an interception. It could have been an incomplete pass if he had gone up and fought for it a little bit more from Eric Coleman. The receivers really had another bad game. Not much went right for the Jaguars offensively. Defensively, they had a couple stops early, but they were really eaten alive by Calvin Johnson and Michael Ashore. It's a bad team, really. I mean, what else can you say about the Jaguars at this point? They'll have a Thursday night home game against the Colts, which will be national televised. Maybe that'll change the fact. They've had games where they've surprised on national TV. They had the Ravens game last year where they came out of nowhere and had a decent game against the Ravens at home. But at this point, I might have to trade in this hat for this hat. So we'll see at this point. It's looking more and more like a lost season, so... At this point, they're tied with the Chiefs, 1-7 for the first pick of the draft. And the Panthers actually look like they're going to pull out a win against the Redskins. So it might just be a two-team race for that number one pick now. And who knows which direction the Jaguars will go in with that if they so happen to get it. This is Adam Stites from Big Cat Country. Be sure to subscribe on YouTube and check us out on bigcatcountry.com.